Hi, this is Vanessa, and welcome back to Skipping with Jesus. I have a word that was given to me by God the Father. It was God the Father's voice that gave this word to me on the morning of June the 30th of 2024 at 2:29 a.m. And the title of this spoken word is A Mighty Awakening. A Mighty Awakening. And I don't know about you, but there is like this sense of expectation in my spirit of what Abba is about to do. Well, he's already started. He's already began. And there is just a quaking in me, an excitement, like even greater than a child on Christmas morning. Of course, he taught me to be like a child, and so everything that he has, I just like, oh, it's going to be so exciting. And I believe that this mighty awakening that he's doing is going to be beyond anything we could have ever imagined. Now, Heavenly Father, here am I, Abba. Thank you for trusting me with this spoken word that you released to me to scribe for you. And now I will release it through the help of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, take over my vessel, speak through me. Let this word awaken our spirits to not only the time, but what the Father's will is for this time. What he is doing throughout the world. Let us see through spiritual eyes. Then Lord, those that are blind, I pray the scales fall off their eyes and they begin to see what is happening in the supernatural, that you are just rolling in from the kingdom, from your throne. Holy Spirit, here am I. Speak through me, through my voice. You have complete control of me. Thank you for your presence that I sense so palpable. Thank you. Thank you for your indwelling presence. Jesus, I love you and I worship you as King and Lord of my life. I thank you for being my Savior. I love you and I praise you. Holy Spirit, here am I. Speak through me. A mighty awakening. And so in the written word, and of course this was the timestamp of 2:29 was relevant in that the Holy Spirit led me to Revelations 2:29 in the New Living Translation, and it says, anyone with ears to hear must listen to the Spirit and understand what he is saying to the churches. Anyone with ears to hear must listen to the Spirit and understand what he is saying to the churches. And I'm going to encourage you, if you feel like you don't have the ears to hear what the Spirit is saying, I would encourage you to go to the Lord and ask that he opens your ears and remove the blinders from your eyes. So this is what our Lord said. There is a mighty awakening coming in a tsunami of my glory rolling over my church. I am pruning and purging the iniquities of the double-minded out of my body. Along with the awakening will be a mighty walking away from me because of those that have held man as their God. They have no relationship with me. Having built their house on sand, they will crumble and fall. This awakening is a part of the shaking I am doing in my church. I am cleansing and clearing out of my church those things not of me and my kingdom. Those that have built on a firm foundation with me as their cornerstone, pray for the souls that are lost in the shaking. They did not respond in private to the Holy Spirit's conviction of their sin. Therefore, those that do not repent in private will be exposed publicly. Out of my love for them, I will expose the evil of their dark ways. They are far away from me, blinded by the enemy's lies. Through my mercy, I have extended my grace for them to repent and be forgiven of their sins, so that on judgment day, they will hear me say, "Well done." It grieves my heart for their sin, but it does not stop me from loving them because I love them. I discipline them and do not put them to death, but I give them hope. For what kind of father would I be if I did not discipline my children? I am a good, loving father, desiring that my children have a pure and holy heart. Therefore, I discipline out of my love and grace for them. Which of you fathers, if your son asks for a fish, will give him a snake instead? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? Or which one of you, if your child asks for bread, you would give him a stone? Furthermore, what kind of father would I be to leave my children standing in a pit of snakes and scorpions, weighed down with stones around their ankles? I am a good father, never taking away my love for my child. I sent my son to rescue the lost and dying from the pit of death, darkness, and evil destruction, giving them a way out from those things that tie them down to their sin. My child, if you have found yourself experiencing my discipline in the shaking I am doing in my church, repent, repent, and turn from your wicked ways. Walk into the awakening of my glory being poured out. For this is not like any other awakening I have ever released throughout the earth. This awakening is bringing my kingdom to earth, preparing for my son's return for his bride, says God Almighty. I pray, Holy Spirit, that this word goes out to those hearts that you have been speaking to in private, and that they respond in private by repenting of their sins and turning from their wicked ways, so that in public you do not have to expose their sins. I pray this in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I pray that this word goes out and finds the fertile ground that the Holy Spirit has prepared. I love you all. May God's face shine upon you. I love you. And until next time, may He find us faithful in skipping down those uncharted paths with His Son. And if you haven't subscribed, or if you know someone that could benefit from God's channel, everybody can benefit. So if you could just forward and to your friends and family, and because I believe there are more that God wants His to release His spoken words to, through warnings, through His love and grace, that the Holy Spirit is drawing prodigals back to Him. This is a time that His glory is being poured out, and we do not want to miss this Kairos moment in establishing His kingdom on earth to bring in His harvest, His last great harvest. I love you. We'll talk to you later. See you next time. Bye-bye.